What is up, guys? TechBit Sean here. Today, we're going to take a look at what Microsoft Viva is and explore whatever information that Microsoft has chosen to share with us about their brand new platform. Microsoft Viva is aimed at enhancing employee experience for remote work, and it's integrated within Microsoft Teams itself. So far, it seems that there's not going to be a platform dedicated for Viva itself. Instead, the product is spread across the entire Microsoft 365 environment, and all the functionalities will also be integrated within Microsoft Teams as well. I would say there's definitely a concern in the performance toll that it might take, since Teams is not exactly an ideal experience on lower end PCs as it is right now, due to just being a memory hog. So with the addition of Viva, it would definitely be interesting to see how they accommodate it without actually making it even worse. Especially since it seems that using Viva is going to be a very important productivity tool, and if they're planning on having a majority of people take advantage of that, it would definitely be ideal if they were to optimize it for that experience. So there's four parts of Microsoft Viva: Viva Connections, Viva Insights, Viva Learning, and Viva Topics. Let's get into each one, check the release dates, pricing, and things we just know about the platform so far. I want to apologize in advance if I'm not using any footage of myself using Microsoft Viva, since a lot of these features really require data that has been collected, and I don't have such resources with me at the moment. Instead, I'll be using footage from Microsoft blogs and others. I'll show a reference to their content as it is being shown, or I'll leave a link in the description as well. With that being said, let's get started. Viva Topics is already available as an add-on for commercial users, and it costs $5 a month per user, which is pricey if you consider the fact that the entire Business Basic subscription costs just as much. But if you really want to check if it'll be worth it for your organization, there is a free 30-day trial for 25 users, so you can go and check that out. Microsoft's goal using Viva Topics is to significantly reduce the amount of time people spend looking for information. They use what's called topic cards, topic pages, and topic centers, which are areas containing consolidated information on specific topics that your employees may want to access at any given time. And it does this by using Microsoft's artificial intelligence or AI technology, so that you don't have to manually create any of these content pages, which some of you might be using communication sites or content management applications to do. But just know that you will be able to create topic pages manually if you wish to do so, and usually you will have to do this if the AI doesn't deem that enough information exists in your environment to create a topic page out of. So let's look at an example. Say that your organizations develop a software called Bingo, and whenever the term Bingo is mentioned in team conversation, SharePoint sites, and basically throughout your entire Microsoft 365 environment, the word gets underlined and you can hover over it to be shown a topic card, which gives you some information like the people who are involved who may have some knowledge on that particular topic, resources, related topics, and if you click on the card, it will take you to a topic page which will show you a description of what the topic is, alternative names and acronyms for it, and more resources which you can use to better understand that particular subject in detail. Some use cases that I can mention where this would really come in handy is when you onboard new employees or you assign existing projects to people who have no idea what the project is about, or even someone who is experienced on the topic but needs a refresher because they've been out of touch for a while. Instead of having to worry about spending excessive times training them, you can let Viva Topics do kind of the hard work for you. Of course, you will have to set the descriptions and acronyms and stuff manually, but the rest of the job is done automatically by the AI. There's also a neat feature that is coming up with Viva Topics, which lets you ask specific questions about the topic, and if the answer exists, it returns information regarding it, or it sends the question through to the knowledge experts and gives you the feedback. It also adds this question or answer to the topic itself, making it generally available for everyone who checks it out in the future. So that's basically what Viva Topics is about. And yes, it is a user-based license, so you will have to purchase individual Viva Topic licenses for anyone thinking of taking advantage of the feature set. Microsoft is also working on having this work with applications other than Office 365. So in the future, you will be able to integrate it with external applications and even external content management applications using content connectors and APIs. The next one that's already available to use is Microsoft Insights, which is another AI-powered tool. And you can install this right now if you have the Workplace Analytics subscription, which as of right now is available as an add-on for enterprise subscriptions. You can do this by heading to your Teams, going into apps and searching for Insights. Now at this point, Insights can be split into two sections. the Personal Insights and the Manager and Leader Insights. Personal Insights contains two features, Stay Connected and Protect Time. The Stay Connected portion uses artificial intelligence to help you not fail to meet your commitments. It lets you prioritize certain people, let's say your managers or maybe critical clients, and stay on top of the commitments you've made with them so that you don't miss anything. There's also a frequency meeting option you can set up. So let's say, for example, you wanted to maintain a close relationship with your clients. You can set one-on-one meeting frequencies up, let's say monthly, and Viva Insights will remind you of the meeting. And even if you were to miss it, or let's say you have a conflicting event at the time of the meeting, it reminds you to reschedule with a prompt. The AI also finds commitments, requests, and follow-ups mentioned in your email, your Outlook, either by you or the people you are speaking with, and then it suggests tasks accordingly. Like if someone were to say that you should meet to get something done, but doesn't exactly schedule a meeting or time to do it, the task suggestion in Insights will automatically pick it out and let you know that it needs attention. There are a few other things under Stay Connected, like if someone were to share a file with you that you haven't yet accessed, it reminds you to do that. If your important contacts have mentioned you specifically on Teams using at mentions, it collects this and gives you easier access to it. And if you have any upcoming meetings that you've forgotten to RSVP for, it gives you task suggestions to get that done as well. The second portion of Personal Insights is aimed at improving your productivity and is called Protect Time, which lets you use focus time to block out unnecessary notifications which could be distracting you from getting your work done. So essentially, if you want to allocate a certain amount of time that you're planning on sitting and working with absolute certainty that you will be dedicating those hours for your work, then it helps you to do just that. What's really nice about Insights is the dashboard that you can see here, which lets you do simple things like praise your colleagues, or it just reminds you to take a break, giving you some breathing exercises. I think this is wonderful, the direction they're headed with this, and especially because they plan on integrating Headspace, the meditation and sleep application, into Insights itself. Manager and Leader Insights is aimed at, well, managers and leaders, which gives you two sections called My Team and My Organization. They both provide a statistical overview of your team, and then it gives you recommended actions or best practices that you can implement to improve certain aspects of your team or your organization. It's mainly aimed at really giving you a good look at your employees' habits and how it may affect their effectiveness. And more than anything, bringing this up with your employees can really make them feel as if you were invested in their routines and their well-being, which, if you were really using this feature, you genuinely are. I think Insights is a great way of bridging that gap in communication between employers and employees. Viva Connections is planned to be released very soon. Hopefully, we'll be seeing it in late March or April for the desktop experience within Teams. And for mobile, they plan to release it in the summer, so somewhere between June and September. The best part about Viva Connection is that it comes with your SharePoint Online license. So if you have any Microsoft 365 subscriptions, which includes SharePoint Online, you will be licensed for Viva Connections. Since there is no release of Viva Connections, I can't accurately describe to you exactly what it's going to be, but I am going to try and give you the facts that have been shared publicly in Microsoft Ignite and the blog posts by Microsoft themselves. Viva Connections is said to be a personalized experience for each employee, and it seems to be making a priority out of connecting employees regardless of their departments, their positions, and whatever else to be providing an inclusive workplace environment. Now, all this is not going to be done entirely automatically because Viva Connections take into consideration things like your SharePoint sites, your Yammer communities, your Microsoft Stream content, and so it does require you to have these set up beforehand to really maximize its potential. It also seems that due to the fact that it is going to be aiming at providing personalized content, some thought needs to be put in by the administrators taking care of Viva Connections to really plan what type of content is going to target which specific employee groups. The screenshots that we have of Viva Connections shows you the entire homepage that is provided within Teams, just completely changing the experience you have with Microsoft Teams itself. This is partly why I'm worried for the memory consumption issues within Teams, because this really seems to be changing the entire interface. So with Connections, you're getting news and announcements to reach your employees with a very convenient dashboard within Teams itself, which they're already probably using quite a lot. Unlike maybe SharePoint, which employees, or not every employee really, takes the time and visits. In addition, they can take part in communities, making Yammer something that is probably finally going to be embraced by more organizations. And when it comes to live events and videos that will be shared on Connections, one of the most interesting parts will be the automatic AI transcriptions that is going to be generated so that those who prefer to have a subtitled content in their own native language can consume it that way. I'm fairly sure that this is not going to apply for every single language, because I remember Microsoft Stream had a similar feature previously when you would record your team's meetings, but only a limited number of languages were supported. So that's basically what we know about Viva Connections. They have said additional features will be added as time goes on, probably in 2022. So we have a lot to look forward to how they're going to improve this platform. In my opinion, Connections is amazing, but the mobile release is going to make the experience much easier and probably will make employees more likely to consume the content due to the way that it's designed, almost as if it were a social networking application just for your intranet instead. Finally, we have Viva Learning, which will be going into public preview in April. But as of right now, there's no confirmed commercial release date. But we're going to hopefully be seeing it in 2021, and it's exciting for organizations that are really struggling with providing training or educational content without creating disparate accounts on various platforms. Instead, using Viva Learning, what you can do is bring that training content together into Microsoft Teams so your employees can have easy and efficient access to the material. As of right now, Microsoft has partnered with Cornerstone, Coursera, Pluralsight, edX, Skillsoft, and SAP SuccessFactors. It even lets you connect your LinkedIn learning courses so that you can directly access it from your Microsoft Teams. Those are some big names providing some of the best training materials available online, and I have no doubt that Microsoft is going to keep growing their partnerships to make Viva Learning the perfect consolidated learning center. So let's look at some of the cool features that you get with Viva Learning. First, you'll be able to assign courses for your employees from within Microsoft Teams itself and even track the completion status of the course, making sure that your employees are actually learning the material that you assigned for them. You will also be able to create a custom selection of courses within your Microsoft Teams channels and tabs. And as an employee under the My Learning tab, you will be able to see content that has been assigned specifically to you and what the AI deems is appropriate to show you according to the type of content that you consume. You can view the details about the course and like or bookmark them for later. And you will also be able to search for learning content from anywhere within Microsoft Teams. So let's say you want to share a course within a chat, all you need to do is bring up the Viva Learning search and send it through. Those are the features that have been revealed about Viva Learning so far. Now, when it comes to availability of learning content itself, there's no information regarding whether the organization needs to subscribe to the partner platform or if they need to pay for each course or module separately, but this information should be revealed soon. Well, that's basically it for Microsoft Viva. I'm personally very excited for what's to come to the platform, because whatever is released at the moment seems to only scratch the surface. I'll leave a few links in the description that you may want to check out if you want to stay up to date with information regarding Microsoft Viva. I'll hopefully be releasing more Viva-focused content once I get to really provide a hands-on demonstration. But that's it for today. Leave a like if you really found the video useful and subscribe for more. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.